Tonight on NewsWatch, massacre in Newtown, the latest on the Connecticut elementary school shooting.
Plus, Egypt moves toward a new constitution. Why some say this weekend's vote was full of violations.
And how Operation Blessing is working to help those who are still displaced after Superstorm Sandy. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. Good evening. I'm Lori Johnson.
And I'm Mark Martin. Schools in Connecticut and around the country stepped up security today. It's the first day of classes since the massacre of 25 first graders and staff at Sandy Hook Elementary School in Newtown. Investigators say it could take months to put together all the events that led to the shooting spree. State police say they still have to interview many witnesses, including the young children who survived the carnage.
Any interviews with any children will be done with professionals, with parents.
Police say the shooter, 20-year-old Adam Lanza, carried an arsenal of weapons, including a military-style rifle and hundreds of rounds of ammunition, as well as two handguns. They say he only stopped firing and turned the gun on himself when he heard police arriving.
As we begin to learn more about the shooter, it's also time to remember the victims. The first funerals were held today in Newtown. The morning after, President Obama met with families and spoke at a prayer vigil. For people in the community, the terrible reality has set in, but the pain has only just begun. As Jennifer Wishon reports, pastors there hope to turn the community's eyes toward Jesus.
Jesus died for all the children, all the children of the world.
Songs, prayers, and memorials are everywhere across Newtown. A steady line of pilgrims walk the hill towards Sandy Hook Elementary School to remember the 26 students and brave teachers who died there. Christmas trees are decorated for the victims. A memorial of flowers, teddy bears, and candles bring visitors to tears. People come and go, but the feeling of sadness never leaves. Yusuf Haytar walked the hill with his 6-year-old son.
We don't know why things happen, but they do happen, unfortunately. There is, you know, there is evil. There's an abundance of evil in the world, and we have to confront it.
Some give thanks that their children survived.
She heard everything, you know, the shots. Doors slamming, people yelling.
I called my friend and we felt so bad saying this, but we're like, thank God it's not our kids' school.
Just a week before the shootings, children and their families were here for a happy tradition, the lighting of the town Christmas tree. People who were here say the air was full of excitement over the coming celebration of the birth of Christ.
There's face painting and all the stores are open and there's Christmas music and everybody's running around, and then at 6 o'clock they light the tree and everybody goes, woo, right there. And now there's two donated trees to mourn the dead people. It's pretty bad.
It's very difficult for this area. We always say it could never happen to us, and it's happening to us.
At a prayer vigil Sunday, President Obama offered comfort by reminding residents the nation grieves with them.
Let the little children come to me, Jesus said, and do not hinder them, for to such belongs the kingdom of heaven. God has called them all home.
Some churches are keeping their doors open 24 hours for prayer. St. Rose of Lima Catholic Church was hit especially hard. It will handle 8 of the funerals. Some children, the shooter's mother, and the shooter all attended the church. For Sunday Mass, it was standing room only. The church is where people came after learning the news and continue to come to reflect and heal. Sunday sermons across the region focused on the tragedy.
There is no one like our God.
The minister of this church is uniquely suited for this moment. More than a decade ago, he pastored a church near Columbine High School when 2 teens killed 13 people.
It's an unfortunate privilege, I guess, to have been through 2 of these things, but I think in some ways we're probably prepared to deal with some of the issues that are going to arise over the next week for us.
Emotions of shock, sorrow, and anger.
For the children, innocent children, this never should have happened. How could this happen? only God knows.
God can win with any hand that's dealt. And so even when a bad hand is dealt, God has a way of turning things.
In many ways, this idyllic New England community will never be the same. The hurt will linger long after the president, grief counselors, and TV cameras leave. But there is hope that the pain will open hearts to God's love and peace.
Man, keep us lifted in prayer because God will give us the answers. He'll help us tell people what they need to hear. And we don't always know what to say, but we know he does. So pray for us.
Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Newtown, Connecticut.
The massacre at Sandy Hook Elementary School is the latest of many mass shootings. With violent video games and entertainment becoming normal, some blame America's culture of violence for such crimes. At the same time, others are pointing to gun control regulations.
The vast majority of gun users are law-abiding citizens, but authorities say the millions of guns in circulation guarantee that disturbed people will often be able to get their hands on them, even in sleepy communities like Newtown, Connecticut. Experts say in America, unless you have a felony conviction or you are found by a court to be mentally incompetent, you have ready access to firearms. California Senator Dianne Feinstein plans to introduce legislation to ban new assault weapons. Colorado Governor John Hickenlooper says his state has put new safeguards in place to help identify potentially dangerous individuals after the theater shooting in Aurora.
Almost $20 million in new programs around trying to put more support for people with mental illness to make sure that we have a 24-hour hotline that someone can call in if they think someone appears unstable, a danger to themselves or others.
Outgoing Connecticut Senator Joe Lieberman says there needs to be a national commission on mass violence that studies, among other problems, the impact of violent video games and movies.
I spent enough time on this question of violence in the entertainment culture to reach this conclusion that the violence in the entertainment culture, particularly with the extraordinary realism to video games, movies now, etc., does cause vulnerable young men, particularly, to be more violent.
President Obama is vowing to use, quote, whatever power his office holds to protect the nation's children from gun violence. He plans to consult law enforcement, mental health professionals, parents, and educators in the coming weeks.
For more now, we turn to psychiatrist Dr. Carl Benzio. He's the executive director and founder of Lighthouse Network. Dr. Benzio, thanks for joining us.
Hey, great. Thanks for having me.
So do you think we're a culture of violence and that plays into tragedies like this, or does it really just come down to a mental health issue?
Well, I think anything like this sad tragedy of the other day, horrific situation, is complex. And so there's a bunch of different parameters that come into play. Certainly mental health issues, our society, 34% this year will have a significant mental health issue, 61% in their lifetime in the United States. So it's a very prevalent situation, but there's not that many services or people have trouble accessing services. So that's always part of the problem in these kind of situations. But certainly as you look at our society, the increase in violence over the last several years, probably the last 30 or 40 years since the 60s and 70s, have just been increasing year after year. And these tragic events, unfortunately, aren't so uncommon anymore.
Mm-hmm. And do you think that as far as this case is concerned, that there were some warning signs that people missed? And what's the difference between someone with issues and someone who's capable of such violence like we saw on Friday?
Yeah, you know, the tipping point in these kind of situations is always hard to predict. Certainly some warning signs in classical situations are if somebody has a history of violent behavior, if there's drugs and alcohol going on, if there's a lot of impulsive behavior. And in this kind of situation, that doesn't seem to be the case. And what I've seen is there's usually two extremes. We're obviously trying to stereotype here a little bit, but there's two extremes. One is that person who's always acting out, bullying, violent, threatening, impulsive, destructive kind of person almost all the time. And you can just see the anger soothing from them. The other person is the one who's quiet, who's shy, who hasn't really connected, doesn't have a whole lot of supports, self-esteem, confidence, social skills have a struggle. And so they keep a lot of their hurt and their pain inside. They're very passive with their ability to deal with conflict and to manage conflict. And so that builds up over years. And unfortunately, this particular perpetrator in this situation. Sounds like there were a lot of struggles in his background, very shy, very introverted, and sounds like a lot of pressure built up over years, and we don't know what that last straw that broke the camel's back was. But if a person doesn't learn how to understand their negative feelings, how to harness them, and how to express them properly, a lot of dysfunctional things can come out, whether that's dysfunctional behavior towards themselves or dangerous behavior to others.
Mm-hmm. Very insightful. So much we could talk about, but we're out of time. But thank you so much, Dr. Carl Benzio, and we appreciate your time.
Oh, sure. Thank you.
Turning overseas tonight, Israel is moving ahead with plans to build homes on a contested piece of land in East Jerusalem. A government committee approved today the construction of 1,500 housing units in an area Palestinians claim for a future capital. Israel's interior ministry says the project still has to go through planning stages and could take years. Even so, the announcement is expected to anger Palestinians and others who oppose settlement construction in the occupied West Bank and East Jerusalem.
In nearby Egypt, Islamists appear to have won a narrow victory in the first round of voting on a new constitution, but Egyptian rights groups are calling for a revote, charging widespread violations. Our Middle East bureau chief Chris Mitchell has that story.
The opposition umbrella group condemned the irregularities and violations, including the presence of the Muslim Brotherhood at the polls. It called for a large rally against the Constitution.
We call on our great Egyptian people in all their sectors to go down on Tuesday, December 18th, to the streets to defend their free will, prevent its forgery, and bring down the void draft Constitution.
Millions of Egyptians cast their vote in the referendum on the Constitution. It would empower Islamists to enforce the most widespread and strictest implementation of Islamic or Sharia law that modern Egypt has ever seen.
I cannot accept a constitution with very limited rights for minorities, rights for women, rights for even children. It's not suitable for Egypt, actually. We're talking about a country that has been in place for over 210 years as a modern state.
Rights groups said violations included women being prevented from voting because they were not wearing Islamic veils, individuals falsely identifying themselves as judges, and Christians being denied entry to polling stations. As polls closed, hundreds of Islamists attacked the offices of one of Egypt's oldest liberal parties.
The president, if he is president of all Egyptians, holds the responsibility of what has happened now. And I ask the Attorney General to submit the criminals who attacked us to justice.
Israelis are watching the Egyptian vote with concern, since an Islamist victory could threaten the 33-year peace treaty between Egypt and Israel. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Coming up, converting to coins. Why some say the move could save America big.
It's probably something I've had for many years, and every year the PSA would be a little higher. I just kept kind of ignoring it. You know, one of those guy things. It'll go away. It'll go away. Finally, one day, Janet says, "You're going to the doctor." They did a blood test. My PSA was 14. I needed to get a second opinion, so we contacted Cancer Treatment Centers of America.
To find out more about Cancer Treatment Centers of America and our unique treatment options for complex and advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com.
The really great thing is that you just go online, and if you have prostate or lung cancer or whatever, you can see what their survival rates are.
You can also check for participating insurance plans. Cancer Treatment Centers of America is different. You feel it the moment you call or walk into one of our hospitals. It's state-of-the-art medicine, unique treatment options, and a level of compassion that cannot be copied. Why? Our people. People who give you not only their expertise, but their humanity and the most thoughtful, well-organized, patient-centered care you'll find anywhere.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America go way beyond what normal hospitals do. I knew that they had the technology to take care of my cancer. It's a device called Calypso.
Calypso is GPS for the prostate. We're able to get four-dimensional, real-time tracking of prostate movement during radiation treatment.
It eliminates a lot of my side effects. It makes sense. It just makes sense. I own a deli. I'm back at work. My customers come in and say, "Gosh, you look good." And some of them say I look better now than I did before I left. I didn't expect to learn a lesson about how to treat people by being in a hospital. You can tell when somebody really cares.
Every minute counts when you're fighting complex or advanced stage cancer. So please call or visit cancercenter.com today. Appointments are available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Care that never quits.
South Carolina Governor Nikki Haley announced today she will appoint Representative Tim Scott to the Senate. Scott will replace Senator Jim DeMint, who is leaving in January to head up the Heritage Foundation. State law gives Haley the authority to pick DeMint's successor. Senator-designate Scott will become the only African-American currently serving in the Senate and the first black Republican senator from the South since Reconstruction in the 1800s.
President Obama and House Speaker John Boehner met this morning to try and tackle the fiscal cliff crisis. The speaker's latest offer allows the Bush tax rates to expire for those making more than $1 million a year. In exchange, Boehner's looking for $1 trillion in spending cuts from programs like Medicare. His deal also includes raising the debt ceiling to fund the government for a year before the issue would have to be revisited. The president has not rejected the proposal, but some say he has concerns about aspects of it. Well, if Congress is seeking ways to save money, there's one place they might not have considered: exchanging paper money for coins.
Yeah, some say the conversion could save America $4.5 billion. Paul Strand takes a look at the move to get Americans to make the change.
7 times now, the Government Accountability Office has begged Congress to abandon the bill. But lawmakers don't like offending voters, and the Federal Reserve, a coin opponent, says 3/4 of Americans don't want the change. Coin fans say that number nearly reverses to 61% support when Americans find out how much the switchover would save.
$4.4 billion savings over 30 years. And if we actually take a look at what happened in Canada, they blew past their projections of savings.
Congress recently heard Canada save more than 10 times what it thought it would when Canadians unexpectedly went loony for the $1 loony coin. And it's a happy accident. There's a loon on it instead of a French-Canadian explorer.
Dyes were shipped to Winnipeg and were lost. And it was not a loon that was supposed to be the design on the $1 coin. It was supposed to be a voyageur. The dyes have never been found. It was a major snowstorm. Nobody ever knows. As a result of that, the Canadian government immediately made the decision to bring the loon design up. The loon design caught on and was called a loony.
The Canadians say one other key was they replaced paper bills fast.
Once you get that done, people are quite happy. The loon up there is very popular.
Former Reagan budget director Jim Miller scoffs at that idea.
Are you really prepared to force users, voters, to use a means of exchange they clearly reject out of hand?
Opponents point out 3 times the mints failed to sell the coin. Former Congressman Jim Colby of the Dollar Coin Alliance says there's more to that than meets the eye, like what happened with the Sacagawea buck.
There was a tremendous demand for it, and in fact, the mint took to directly sending these to Walmart, and there were lines at Walmart stores of people trying to get the Sacagawea coins.
But the Federal Reserve distributes all our money, and the Fed itself makes profit from selling only paper money, so it began choking off the coins.
The merchants, they found it more difficult to get the coins to keep in their drawers because the Federal Reserve Board wasn't making it easy for them to get it. You see, the Federal Reserve Board gets the profit from making the paper dollars. The mint gets the profit from making all coins.
If the coin ever does take off, much of the saving, financially and environmentally, will come from getting rid of a paper bill that wears out in 2 to 4 years.
A coin lasts for 30 years, at least, before it gets so degraded that you can't use it anymore. And then you can melt it down and reuse it. You can't do that with paper. You have to pulp it and then shred it, and then it goes into landfills. Tons and tons and tons of landfill every year are paper dollars that are shredded up.
A final point, we'd have fewer coins to sort out and save a huge bundle by also getting rid of the pennies and nickels that now cost more to make than they're worth.
A penny costs about 2.4 cents to mint, and a nickel costs 11.1 cents to mint.
More than 70% of the mints production goes into making pennies, which you just drop on the street or you put into a jar someplace.
But is all this change Americans will buy? Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.
Up next, answering the call of those in crisis, the work of Operation Blessing in the Sandy-devastated Northeast.
Listen up for an amazing offer that can change the way you hear.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Can you repeat that?
Frustrated with your hearing?
What did he say?
Well, hear better now. Introducing the fully rechargeable MSA30X, a revolutionary device that features the latest microsound amplification technology that can barely be seen. Independently tested to help you hear up to 30 times better. It turns ordinary hearing into extraordinary hearing. MSA30X works by capturing and amplifying sound waves. Yet its lightweight, ergo-acoustic design is discreet. It form fits in and around either ear.
I forget I'm even wearing it.
And MSA30X is powerful. Hear clearly in restaurants. Never miss another word on TV or at the movies.
My wife complains that I have the volume up on the TV too loud.
And I didn't want to be in the same room with them.
Now I can hear everything clearly.
Simply adjust the volume as you desire. Other units use so many batteries, and they're difficult to change. But MSA30X is completely rechargeable. Simply plug it into the wall.
I tried other devices that had batteries, but they were always such a pain to change and so costly. But this is rechargeable, so I figure I save hundreds a year.
Not hearing the way you should? Don't settle for bulky sound amplifiers that can cost hundreds when you can try MSA30X for just $39.95. But wait, in this special TV offer, we'll cut the price in half. Did you hear that? In half. It's the MSA30X Hear Better Now offer. For a limited time, just $19.95. And it's backed by a money-back guarantee. As an extra bonus with your charging base, we'll also include a cleaning brush and five soft comfort tips. The MSA30X Hear Better Now offer. Just $19.95.
All I can say is just try it. It could change your life.
Call or go online today.
To order the MSA30X sound amplifier, call 1-800-920-1526. That's 1-800-920-1526, or go to buymsa30x.com. Call now.
It's been more than 6 weeks since Superstorm Sandy hit the Northeast, but FEMA officials say some people may have to wait months more before they can go back to their storm-devastated homes.
That's why Operation Blessing is on the ground, giving much-needed hope to one New Jersey town.
You just see your home all ripped up, or some have seen their homes in water, and it's just devastating because that's where you have your family, you have a lot of memories.
In the wake of Hurricane Sandy's devastating blow to the Northeast, one of the hardest hit yet less publicized areas is Little Egg Harbor, New Jersey. Damage in this small community was among the worst in the affected areas. When the cry went out to help families in this crisis, Operation Blessing answered the call.
It's such a little tucked away little town that almost, I don't want to say forgotten, but almost a little forgotten town, because they haven't had really anybody else in here to help them. And we just happened to be placed here.
People here weren't allowed back into their homes for days after the storm. When they returned to see what was left of their homes, they needed help clearing out damaged walls, furniture, and lifelong memories. And most of all, they wanted to salvage whatever they could. That's where Operation Blessing volunteers came in.
Before they even, you know, throw anything out, they ask me, they double ask me. Very, very professional and very, you know what, the caring and the kindness that they are displaying is just unbelievable, wonderful.
They even told me, oh, thank you for letting me come in your house. And I was like, oh, thank you for being here. The feeling I got. The only thing I could honestly think of, it was like it was raining angels.
This means an awful lot to me. I will never forget it. They're cordial, they're kind. They've really been protective, like you have a friend. In this case today, I have many.
With your help, Operation Blessing will continue to meet the needs of those affected by Hurricane Sandy and others who have met unforeseen tragedies around the world.
All you folks that have donated, God bless you all. And I mean, it's the best thing that you could have ever donated to.
It's the kind of organization you want to support because they do help people. We see that. We see that firsthand.
Wow, Operation Blessing at work once again. To find out how you can help Operation Blessing, visit our website, cbnnews.com. We'll be right back.
cbnnews.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7.
Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
Ow, my feet hurt.
My feet hurt, your feet hurt. White hot pain, I wanna cry. Is there anything I can try?
Why, yes. Introducing Strut Soul Angels, the human shock absorber that helps alleviate foot pain.
The first 10 steps in the morning to the bathroom were excruciating. Within 3 days after I put Struts on, it's been such a relief.
Slipped it on and almost immediately I felt a support, kind of like a pillow underneath my arches.
The Struts Soul Angel provides a great amount of relief and support throughout the course of the day, providing shock absorption and relief of pain.
On your feet without proper support can be painful. Struts Soul Angels promotes better balance, control, and body alignment. Standing in your heels all day is painful, but slip on Struts and you'll enjoy comfort and support 24/7. Struts is so versatile, you'll wear them in every shoe you own, even barefoot.
I'm on my feet all the time. I teach 11 and 12-year-olds. The pain was so much that I knew I had to do something. And with the Struts, I can do my job and enjoy my job.
I usually am on my feet from 8 to 12 hours a day. When I wear my Struts, it's like giving my feet a hug all day.
It's life-changing. I wear them from the minute I get up to the minute I go to bed.
Why pay $400 for custom orthotics?
Now get Struts Soul Angels for just $10. You also get Miracle Foot Repair Cream, absolutely free. Use it to help relieve dry, callous feet overnight. But wait, call right now and we'll double the offer free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Plus, you get a 100% money-back guarantee. If not completely delighted, send it back, but keep the foot cream as our gift just for trying. You get it all, a $70 value for just $10.
Oh, yes!
Love my Struts, the best thing since sliced bread. The heel pain from toes to head. Get yours now, your doctor said.
Struts, be nice to your feet. Call now.
Call 1-800-787-1580 and get your Struts and Miracle Foot Repair for just $10 and we'll double the offer. That's 1-800-787-1580 or visit GetStruts.com.
The birthplace of Jesus got a dose of Christmas spirit this weekend.
Hundreds of people attended the annual tree lighting ceremony in the town of Bethlehem. Performers sang Christmas carols and fireworks lit up the sky to mark the event. And that beautiful tree is located in the square in front of the Nativity Church. Wow, they got a lot of people out there. Bethlehem is one place I would love to visit you too.
Especially on Christmas Eve. Yeah. A little town of Bethlehem. That would be great. One of these days.
And right in front of the Church of the Nativity. Yeah. It's neat.
Well, that's all the time we have for this edition of NewsWatch.
Remember, you can email us your comments and questions at newswatch@cbn.com. Hope you'll join us next time.